everybody. Here we are, all ready to take you down to Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner. Brought to you by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. Did you know that this famous original malted milk is the very same one that nutritionists and dietitians are recommending for use in weight control? Here's what they are telling overweight folks to do. To drink a glass full of Horlicks every noontime instead of eating a heavy, hard-to-digest meal with its weight-inducing excess calories. These experts select Horlicks because this specially processed malted milk is an exceptionally well-balanced food and a rich source of the minerals and vitamins essential for proper nourishment. They know that a weight control plan based upon Horlicks is safe as well as effective. So if you want to reduce, follow the advice of medical experts and reduce the Horlick way. You can get Horlicks in half-pound, pound, or five-pound packages at any druggist, in either natural or chocolate flavor. And now, let's see what's happening down in Pine Ridge. Well, Lum, as justice of the peace, has been forced to issue a warrant closing the picture show of his competitor, Squire Skimp. It seems there is an old ordinance in Pine Ridge prohibiting the operation of a theatrical entertainment of any kind on the second floor of any building because of the fire hazard. This places Lum in a rather embarrassing position, as he is afraid there will be some who might think that he has used his office of justice of the peace to fight competition. As we look in on Pine Ridge today, we find Lum and Abner over at the Jot 'em Down store. Now that they have the only picture show in Pine Ridge, the old fellows are taking a renewed interest in their business. Lum has just called their friends on the party line to make an announcement. Listen.
Hey, you better go ahead and start talking, Lum. He'll be hanging up a receiver there.
Yeah, well, be quiet. Howdy, everybody. This is Lum Edwards, advertising manager of the Pine Ridge Planetarium, talking.
Advertising manager?
I've just got a few announcements to make in regards to our picture show.
When did he get to
be I reckon most of you have heard by now that Skimp's Hippodrome's been closed up.
Yeah, goody.
And from now on, we're going to have a different picture every night instead of having them 3 days a week like we've been doing.
Fine. I'm
We're going to do our best to bring you folks your latest pictures.
Yeah.
Another thing, just because we ain't got no competition now, we don't aim to raise our prices none. They're going to stay right where they're at, 10 and 25 cents.
For children and grown.
10 cents for the children and 25 cents for the adults.
That's right.
Now, for tonight, we have for your approval that old favorite, David Copperfield. This is a picture you all ought to see, and something you need to be afraid to bring your youngins to.
Oh.
The show starts prompt at 7 o'clock, and it'll be out by 9:30, so you won't miss too much sleep. We collect the Pine Ridge Planetarium, the place where you see the movie stars, presenting David Copperfield, Come One, Come All. I thank you.
Doggy, that ought to bring him out, Lum.
Sounded all right, did it?
Oh, yes, sirree. You just plumb outdone yourself on that.
After that party line's a handy thing at all for advertising. Nice thing about it, it don't cost nothing either.
No, but ringing that fire alarm so much just, get them to the phone so you can make them speeches, Lum, while you're liable to get them where they wouldn't pay no attention if we was to have a fire showing up.
Yeah, maybe we better start calling Doc Miller's ring for a while. Everybody listens in to see who's down sick when you ring him anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, Abner, looks like we've sort of got our things our way at last now.
Yeah.
Or to make some money out of this picture show business after all.
Yeah, well, only thing that's kept us from it so far has been Squire Skin. But we got him out of the way now.
Yeah, I still don't feel just right about it, though. I dread for the case to come up in my Justice of the Peace Court tomorrow.
Well, I wish you'd quit worrying about that, Lum. It weren't your fault.
Well, I just don't want nobody to think that me and you closed Squire up just to help our own business.
Well, we closed him up because he was a violating the law, running a theater on the second floor of a building. Ain't our fault if he was in the same business that we are.
Well, he thinks we done it just to help ourselves, though.
Oh, yeah, he thinks so. That's what made him so mad yesterday.
I wasn't surprised, old Dad. I figured he'd be mad before he ever went over to serve him papers on it.
Oh, I never seen a man get so mad over anything in my life. He just ranted and raved.
He did, huh?
Yes, sir. If he does all the things that he says he's going to, why, me and you better just stay as far away from him as we can for a while.
stay away from him.
Yeah, I told you what all he said. He weren't joking, neither.
Well, he'll cool off. More than likely today, he haven't any regrets what all he said yesterday.
And he made me so mad, I started once to just slap them handcuffs on him and march him right over to jail and lock him up for calling me all them names. But I never. Oh, he was mad.
Yeah, Squire flies off in the handle, my... Well, for... Looky coming yonder.
Where?
Cedric Wheatham's coming about there.
Well, I do know.
I reckon we knocked Cedric out of a job when we closed Squire up that way.
Well, he's good enough for him. He had no business quitting us in the first place.
Well, he just let Squire talk him into it. That's the trouble. Cedric means well. Makes mistakes like all the rest of us, of course.
Yeah. Oh, well, he's honest, all right. Honest as a day is long. Huh?
Huh?
Yeah, I don't know what I mean by that. How could anybody be as honest as a day is long?
I don't know. You're the one that said it. I've heard it before.
Well, that don't make good sense.
Well, don't argue with me about it. You're the one that said it.
Honest as a day is long. That's the silliest thing I ever heard.
Well, howdy, Cedric. Come in.
Glad to see you, Cedric.
Howdy, do, sir. How y'all?
Why, all right, I reckon, Cedric.
How you been making it, Cedric?
Oh, pretty good, I think. I lost my job over there at Mr. Squire.
Well, that ain't nothing to laugh about, is it, losing your job?
No, Mom, but I was just thinking, here I am back again. Right back where I started at.
Yeah, I see ya.
Yeah, it's a shame Squire's place had to close up, Cedric, and throw you out of work.
Yeah, and it's too bad that we ain't got nothing for you to do neither, Cedric, or we might let you go back to work for us.
Yeah, if Abner hadn't learned how to run that pitcher machine, we might could use you down there at the pitcher show. But we don't need you now.
Yes, Mom.
And we ain't doing enough business here in the store to afford to hire nobody, neither.
No, Mom.
Cedric, you just got to where you're taking us for granted. Just think you can quit and then come back to work anytime you want to.
Yes, Mom, I must be. Must be.
Yeah.
And quit saying yes, Mom, and no, Mom.
Yes, Mom. Or no, Mom. Well, <I'm...
laughs> Old Squire got pretty mad when I filed that warrant on him yesterday, didn't he, Cedric?
You ain't saw him mad yet, though. You ought to see him over today. I just now left over. I went over a while ago to draw my pay, but he was so mad I was scared to ask him first.
Oh, he's unsafe to be around that fella when he gets mad.
I just turned around and walked off. Never said nothing to him about it.
I don't blame you. That's just what I done yesterday.
You fellas ain't got no drinking water around here, have you? No place, don't reckon.
Why, yeah, there's a whole bucket full sitting right over on the counter, Cedric. I just drawed it a while ago, plum fresh.
Yeah, help yourself, Cedric. And keep your hands out of that candy case, though.
And the Cracker Barrel.
Yes, Mom.
And quit saying yes, Mom.
Yes,
sir. One that's all that boy knows. Yes, Mom, and no, ma'am. I'll get tired of hearing it.
Yeah, I reckon Squire just now sort of beginning to realize this ain't no joke closing him up.
Yeah.
He's that mad.
More than likely, the word sort of got passed around, you know, and everybody's joshing him about us getting the best out of him. That's about what makes
me mad. Wouldn't be surprised. Well, ain't no use to get mad about it. That won't help him none.
No, but if I was you, Lum, I'd just stay out of his way for a while yet anyway. Ain't no use to just ag on trouble.
No, but I've got to see him tomorrow afternoon when the case comes up in my court. I'm a-dreading it, too.
Well, maybe he won't hurt you, Lum.
Won't hurt me.
No.
Well, that ain't what I'm worrying about. I just hate to try the case in my court, for I know Squire's going to think that I'm closing him up just to get even with him. And if I don't close him up, why, everybody's going to think I turned him loose because I'm scared of him.
Yeah, well, if I was you and he's turned
well,
up
Well,
my...
one, two, goodness. Look over yonder. Look at Cedric. Straighten up that canned goods and dusting stuff off just like he's working here.
Well, we never give him no job, did we?
Why, no. He just went to work. Now, what you gonna do with a boy like that?
Well, we ought to just fire him.
Well, how we gonna fire him? We ain't even hired him.
Oh, well, I don't know. Looks like he's got her.
Cedric, we told you.
Oh,
never
my goodness, alive, Lum. Look, there comes Squire Skimp, Lum. Look there.
Oh, well, let him come.
Look,
let
Lum,
him come.
We better lock the front door. I don't want you to get hurt now.
Well, don't you worry about me. I'll take care of myself.
I know, but I'm going to get out of here, Lum. I know what he said he's going to do to me. I'm going to leave.
I expect I better leave too, Mr. Lum. I don't want to be around when this thing happens. What time do you want me to be down to the picture show tonight?
Why, about 6:30, I guess, Cedric.
Well, I'll see you down there at 6:30 then.
Well, I'll be back in a little bit, too.
Well, here, Cedric, you ain't working for us. Hold on a minute. Oh, for goodness sake. Reckon we ain't got no say-so about it.
Tom, what's the meaning of all this buffoonery? Closing up my theater. That's the way a card fight competition.
Oh, come in, Squire. Sit down, sit down.
Sit down, nothing. I don't want to sit down. I want an explanation. You can't close my business up with some little law that you made yourself just to fit your own purpose.
Now, Squire, if you'll sit down, I can explain it to you. I can show you the ordinance if you want to see it.
Well, I'd love to see it.
I never had a thing to do with it. The warrant was swore out by two citizens of Pine Ridge, and me and Abner was just carrying out the duties of our office.
Well, now, you're not putting a thing over on me, Lum Edwards. This is your idea all the way through, and I know it. And if you think you can run me out of business with some law that you've concocted yourself, you've got another guess coming, because I ain't going to stand for it.
Well, Squire, your case is set in my Justice of the Peace Court tomorrow afternoon. There'll be plenty of time then to argue the case. I'm sorry if you think that I'm trying to take advantage of you. I wish somebody else was presiding over the case.
Well, I do too, and maybe we'd see justice. But I'll tell you this right now, Lum. If Skimp's Hippodrome is forced to close its doors, if you rule again me in that call tomorrow afternoon, it'll be the biggest mistake you ever made in your life. And just remember, I warned you. Good day.
Well, we wonder what bearing these threats will have on Lum's decision when that case comes to trial tomorrow. By the way, have you ever thought of Horlicks as a cool, refreshing summer drink? Mixed with cold water or milk, I mean, instead of hot. Horlicks, served this way, is an exceptionally good summer drink both for you and your youngsters. Not only cooling and invigorating, but nourishing and sustaining, too. It makes a fine, easy-to-digest lunch for hot, stifling days. One that'll keep you alert and satisfied without the need for heavier food. Keep a pitcher of Horlicks handy in the refrigerator, ready to serve to your family or guests at any time. I can't think of a better suggestion, or one that'll please your family more. Send for Horlicks New Circular, giving original and delightful recipes for cool summer drinks. Just drop a postcard to Horlicks, Racine, Wisconsin, and it'll be sent to you free for the asking. The address is Horlicks, Racine, R-A-C-I-N-E, Wisconsin. This is Carlton Bridges, speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlicks, who now bid you all good night and good health.